Hi everyone, today I am going to perform the experiment number 5, that is to determine the viscosity of liquid sample by using Ostwald viscometer. Okay, so here we have to determine the viscosity of liquid sample. So before we can perform the experiment, we have to discuss the basic introduction of viscosity. So what is the viscosity? See here, viscosity is a measures of fluid resistance to flow. It is a measures of fluid resistance to flow. It means in the path of liquid flow, some resistance is created and that resistance is directly affecting to the flowability of fluid. So how it affecting to the flowability of fluid, okay, and how it measures the fluid resistance to flow. See here, if the liquid sample having the low viscosity, the liquid sample having a low viscous, then their flow is easily or their flow is higher. It means the low viscous sample flow is higher. They are inversely proportional. They are inversely proportional to each other. Okay. If the liquid sample having a high viscosity, it do not flow easily or their flow is very less. So why the high low viscosity having the flow higher? Because the liquid molecules containing the little friction when it is in motion. Okay. Why? If the liquid molecules or in the liquid sample, the molecules containing motions, okay? So, in between the molecules, some frictions is formed. See here, this is a liquid sample. In this liquid sample, the molecules is present. And during the motion period, these molecules frictions or in between the molecules, they are interacts to each other, okay? So, their interaction is very little. Due to the less interaction between the molecules, the low viscosity sample containing the higher flow, okay, and here the high viscosity, in the high viscous liquids, the interaction between the molecules is higher or frictions in between the molecules is higher. Due to their higher frictions, their flow is less. Hence, the low viscosity sample containing the higher viscous, higher flowability, and high viscosity sample containing the low flowability, okay, they are inversely proportional to each other, and hence it describes the internal friction of moving fluids. Internal frictions of moving fluids means whatever fluid is continuously moving, in that fluids molecules containing the interactions or molecules having some interactions, that is the internal frictions. In between the molecules, internal frictions is present, and depends on their internal frictions, their flowability depends. Okay. So the next point is rheology. Rheology terms are related to the viscosity. Viscosity of liquid sample are comes under the rheology term. So what is the rheology? Rheo means to flow. Logos means the science. Okay. That is the rheology. It is the study of flow of liquids. It is the study of flow of liquids. It means if the sample containing the low viscosity, their flowability or their flow of liquid is higher. If the sample containing the higher viscosity, their flow of liquid is less. So the rheology is related to the viscosity terms. Okay, and viscosity of sample, these terms are included or comes under the rheology point. See here, the next point, viscometers. The instrument is used to measure the viscosity of liquid. For determination of viscosity of liquid, we have to use the instrument, and that instrument we can call as the viscometer. Viscometer, by using the viscometer, we can determine the viscosity of liquid sample. So there are two types of the viscometer. First, single point viscometer, and second, multi point viscometer. See here, single point viscometer, this viscometer at single rate of shear, the single point viscometer works. Okay, that is the single point viscometer works at single rate of shear, and multi point viscometer works at several rate of shear. So what is the rate of shear? See here, rate of shear, that is the G. G is called as the rate of shear. G is equals to dV upon dr. This is called as the rate of shear. G is the rate of shear, and rate of shear depends, or rate of shear means it is the change in velocity with change in distance. Okay, the velocity of the liquid sample is changing with change in the distance, that is called as the rate of shear. So here also, the single rate of shear or at single change in velocity with distance, the single point spectrometer is works. But here the several rate of shear is used, then or several rate of shear is included or present in the multi-point viscometers. See, in single point viscometer, there are two types of the single point viscometer. First, capillary viscometer and second, falling square viscometer. Capillary viscometer is also called as the Ostwald viscometer. And in today's practical, we have to use the Ostwald viscometer to determine the viscosity of liquid. Okay? So, Ostwald viscometer is also called as the capillary viscometer. Why? Because in Ostwald viscometer, the capillary tube is present. Hence, it is also called as the capillary viscometer or Ostwald viscometer. Then, see here in multi-point viscometer. Multi-point viscometer contains the two types. First, cup and bob viscometer and second, cone and plate viscometer. Both viscometer we can call as the rotational viscometer. Why? Because in cup and bob, bob is rotating. One part of the viscometer is rotated. Hence, we can use the word rotational. In cone and plate, here the cone part is rotated. Hence, it is called as a rotational viscometer. See at the next point, the single point viscometer. Single point viscometer is applicable to the Newtonian fluid. Okay? So, what is the Newtonian fluid? Newtonian fluid obeys the Newton's laws of equations. Okay? And the Newtonian fluid means the fluid do not change the fluid at which do not change the viscosity with rate of flow. Means as a liquid flow, as a liquid upon use karto hai, Newtonian fluid madhe, ja liquid chi viscosity change hoti tacha rate of flow sobat. That is the fluid do not change the viscosity with rate of flow. The example of Newtonian fluid is water, glycerin, chloroform and acetone. See here the all liquid samples containing the less viscosity, or here the less viscous liquid sample we can use in the single point viscometer. Okay? And in multi-point viscometer, the non-Newtonian fluid as well as Newtonian fluid are present. Okay? It means here the non-Newtonian fluid means they do not obey the Newton's laws of equation. And the fluid non-Newtonian fluid means the fluid in which viscosity is changed with rate of flow. See here the difference. In Newtonian fluid, the viscosities do not change with rate of flow, but here in non-Newtonian fluid, the viscosity is changed with rate of flow. This is the difference between Newtonian fluid and non-Newtonian fluid. And second difference, in single point viscometer, low viscous liquids are included. But in multi-point viscometer, the example is suspension and immersion. It means in multi-point viscometer, higher viscosity liquid samples are included in the multi-point viscometers. Okay? And non-Newtonian fluid containing example, that is the suspension and immersion. Okay? So in today's practical, we have to perform the we can determine the viscosity by using the Ostwald viscometer, and here the we have to use the liquid sample, that is the less viscous liquid sample. So moving towards the next point, that is the principle of Ostwald viscometer. What is the principle of Ostwald viscometer? See here this diagram. In this diagram or in these pictures, here the this part we can call as the wider limb. Okay, this portion we have to call as the wider limb. With the help of this wider limb, we can transfer our liquid sample. Then below the wider limb, this bulb is present. This bulb is large size. This is the bulb 1 and this is the bulb 2. As compared to the bulb 2, bulb 1 is the larger. Okay? Then after the bulb 1, the U-shaped tube is present. This U-shaped tube we can call as a U-tube. Okay? And due to the U-tube is present in Ostwald viscometer, the Ostwald viscometer is also called as the U-tube viscometer. Okay? Why? Because here the U-shaped like tube is present. After the U-tube, this portion we have to call as a capillary tube. See here the in Ostwald viscometer, capillary tube is also present. And due to the capillary tube is present, the Ostwald viscometer is called as the capillary viscometer. Okay? And above the capillary tube, the small bulb is present. This bulb containing the two marks. This is the A mark and this below is the B mark. Okay? Above the bulb 2, A mark is present, and below the bulb 2, B mark is present. Okay? So A mark we can call as the upper mark and B mark we can call as the lower mark. Okay? And this above portion of the here we can attach the rubber bulb or rubber tube. Why we can attach the rubber bulb or rubber tube? we have to attach the rubber ball or rubber tube to serve the liquid. Okay, with the help of that rubber ball, we have to serve the liquid. Whatever liquid is present in bulb 1, that liquid we have to serve in the bulb 2 with the help of rubber ball. Okay, so here in principle, the next point is we can use the test liquid sample to determine the viscosity. Okay, so for determination of viscosity of test liquid sample, we can compare the liquid sample having a known viscosity. अशा लिक्विडसोबत आपण टेस्ट लिक्विड सॅम्पलला कम्पेअर करतोय ज्या लिक्विड सॅम्पलची विस्कॉसिटी आपल्याला ऑलरेडी माहिती आहे. दॅट इज द वी हॅव टू कम्पेअर द लिक्विड सॅम्पल हॅविंग अ नोन विस्कॉसिटी. सो दॅट लिक्विड सॅम्पल वी कॅन कॉल एज अ रेफरन्स लिक्विड सॅम्पल. इट मीन्स फॉर डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ विस्कॉसिटी वी कॅन यूज द टू टाईप्स ऑफ लिक्विड सॅम्पल. फर्स्ट टेस्ट लिक्विड सॅम्पल अँड सेकंड रेफरन्स लिक्विड सॅम्पल. ओके, द रेफरन्स लिक्विड सॅम्पल कंटेनिंग द लिक्विड्स हॅविंग अ ऑलरेडी नोन विस्कॉसिटी. And here the reference liquid sample is distilled water. The distilled water containing the viscosity that is, or the distilled water viscosity is already known, that is 1.0012 poise. Okay, hence the reference liquid is also called as a standard liquid. Okay, first we have to use the reference liquid and then we can use the test liquid in Ostwald viscometer. Now moving towards the next procedure. In procedure, first we have to require the requirements. In requirements, the first chemicals, we can use the two chemicals. First test liquid, test liquid that is the acetone, and in reference liquid water sample. Okay, so water sample as a reference liquid, that is the we have to know their viscosity, that is the 1.0012 poise. Okay, so in next apparatus, in apparatus we can use the beaker, weighing balance, density bottle, stopwatch, Ostwald viscometer. Okay, after that we can use the formula, or we have to use the equation to determine the viscosity of liquid. That is the eta 2 is equals to rho 2 T 2 upon rho 1 T 1 multiplied by rho 1. Okay, by using this equation we have to determine the viscosity of liquid sample. See here, in that eta symbol we can use for the viscosity, rho symbol we can use for the density, and T is called as the time. Okay, so eta 1 and eta 2, small 1 indicates the liquid sample, that is the water or reference liquid sample, and 2 symbol indicates the test liquid sample, that is the acetone. Okay, so eta 1 we can call as the viscosity of reference liquid, that is water. Eta 2 we can call as the viscosity of test liquid, that is acetone. Rho 1 and rho 2, it is the density of reference liquid and test liquid. T1 and T2, it is the time required. T1 means it is the time required for water to reach the from point A to B. Point A to B is present on the bulb, small bulb or bulb 2. Upper mark of the bulb 2 is the point A, and below mark of the bulb 2 is the point B. That when the liquid is passes from the point A to B, that time we can call as the T1. Okay, T1 means the time required for water, and T2 means time required for acetone sample to reaches from point A to B. By using this equation we can determine the viscosity. See here, in this equation density is present. It means the density of reference liquid and density of the test liquid. So first we can determine the density. Okay, so in procedure, the first we have to determine the density by using the density equation or formula. So density is equals to weight of the liquid divided by volume of the liquid, and the unit of the density is gram per ml. See here, the for determination of weight of liquid we can use the W1, W2 and W3. Means we have to determine the W1, W2 and W3. W1, it is the empty weight of the specific gravity bottle. W2 is the weight of the empty specific gravity bottle with water, and W3 is the weight of empty specific gravity bottle with acetone. When you have to minus W2 minus W1, that is weight of empty specific gravity bottle with water, then we can minus W1, that is the weight of empty specific gravity bottle. If we have to minus W2 minus W1, then we can final answer is the weight of water sample, okay, and divided by volume of the water sample. Same for acetone, here also we have to minus the W3 minus W1. If we can minus the W3 to the W1, Then the last or final answer is the weight of the acetone. That is the W3 minus W1, it is called as the weight of the acetone, and W2 minus W1, it is called as the weight of the water. And by using the weight of water and weight of acetone and divided by volume of the water and volume of acetone, we can determine the density of water and acetone. So see here the procedure of how we can determine the density. We can determine the density by using the specific gravity bottle. See here, this is a specific gravity bottle. This specific gravity bottle, first we can take the empty specific gravity bottle weight by using the weighing balance. Okay, first here the weighing balance, then take the weight of empty specific gravity bottle. See here, the weight of the empty specific gravity bottle is 27.63, that is called as the W1. Then note down the weight, that is W1 is equals to 27.63. Then next, we can fill the specific gravity bottle with water sample. Water is used as a reference sample or standard liquid. Completely fill the specific gravity bottle with water sample. Then we have to take the weight of the specific gravity bottle with water sample. This is called as the W2. First tear the weighing balance, then take the weight of water sample with specific gravity bottle, that is called as the W2. See here the weight, 57.95. that means 57.96, it is the weight of the water sample with specific gravity bottle, that is W2. So the W2 weight is 57.94 gram. Then discard the water sample. Then again fill the specific gravity bottle with or by using acetone sample. This is acetone. We can fill the specific gravity bottle by using acetone sample. Then again take the weight of empty specific gravity bottle with acetone sample. First tear the weighing balance, then take the weight. This weight we can call as the W3. It means 52 gram weight of the acetone sample with specific gravity bottle, that is called as the W3. W3, it is the 51.98 gram. Then discard the acetone sample. Then next, by using this reading we can determine the density of the test liquid as well as reference liquid. See here the reading, W1 is the 27.63 gram, W2 is the 57.94 gram, W3 is the 51.98 gram. By using this reading we can determine the density. See here, for determination of density of water, that is the W2 minus W1 upon V. W2 is the 57.94 minus W1 is the 27.63 divided by V. V means volume of liquid sample. We can use the specific gravity bottle, and the volume of that specific gravity bottle is 25 ml. It means we have to use the 25 ml liquid sample. So here we can write down 25. Then after calculation, the final density of the water is 1.2 gram per ml. Then next, rho 2, that is the density of acetone sample. We can put the value in this formula. Then the answer of the density of acetone, that is the 0.97 gram per ml. Okay, so this value we can write down in observation table. See here, in this observation table, here the first water sample is present, and in second column, second row, the test solution, that is the acetone, is present. Okay, so here the first column is time of flow. We can determine the time of flow by using Osmol viscometer. then we can determine their mean time. Okay, we have to take three readings and we can take their average mean time here. Then next column is the density. See, here we can determine the density. So the density of the water is 1.2 gram per ml and the density of the acetone is 0.97 gram per ml. The density of acetone is 0.97 gram per ml. Okay, so here the density is determined, then we can determine the time of flow by using Ostwald viscometer. This is the Ostwald viscometer. In this Ostwald viscometer, this is a wider limb and below the bulb 1 and here the small bulb 2. Okay, see here the small bulb 2, above the small bulb 2 the mark is present. This mark we can call as the A mark, and below the bulb 2 here the mark is present. This mark we can call as the B mark. Below this small, below this bulb 2 the capillary portion is present. This portion we can call as a capillary, or here the capillary tube is present, hence we can call as a capillary viscometer. Okay, this below portion we can call as the U tube. Okay, so hence it is also called as a U tube viscometer. Then this is a bulb 1 and here the wider limb. Okay, then we can attach this Ostwald viscometer to the burette stands. We have to attach this Ostwald viscometer to the burette stand in vertical position. See here, we can attach the Ostwald viscometer in vertical position. Then we have to use the rubber bulb to suck the liquid. First we can use the liquid, that is a reference liquid, that is water. See here, this is a water liquid. We can fill the water liquid in wider limb. See here, bulb 1 is completely filled with water sample. Then we can attach the rubber bulb in second tube here. In second tube we can attach the rubber bulb. Then slowly slowly we can release the rubber bulb. See here, the water is filled in the bulb 1. Okay, we can fill the water in the bulb 1 above the mark A. Water is filled in the bulb 1, or the water is filled in the bulb 1 above the mark A. Then we can reaches the water up to the mark A. Then we can start the stop clock. Here time stop clock is start. Then time required to flow the liquid from mark A to B. When the liquid is flow from mark A to B, that time we can note down by using the stop clock. See here, water is slowly slowly fall down. When water is reaches to the mark B, that time we can note down. See here, water reaches to the mark B and here the time is 2.34 seconds. 2 minutes 34 second time is required to water is fall from mark A to B. So we can note down that time. See here, when water is fall from mark A to B, the time period is required, that is the 2 minutes 34 second. That is the, we have to convert totally in the second, that is the 154 second is required to water is fall from the mark A to B. This reading or this procedure we have to continue, then again two reading we have to take for water sample. It means we can take the average reading. Why? Because for accurate results. We can continue this procedure for three times and then we can take the average reading. That average reading, it is an accurate reading. Then same procedure we can repeat for the test liquid, that is the acetone sample. So see here, this is the acetone sample. We can fill the acetone sample in Ostwald viscometer. Before we can fill the acetone sample, we can discard the water sample. After complete drying the Ostwald viscometer, then we can fill the acetone sample in Ostwald viscometer. First, we can attach the Ostwald viscometer in vertical position. Then, we can fill the acetone sample in wider limb. Then, by using rubber bulb, we have to suck the acetone sample in bulb 2. See here, slowly, slowly, bulb 1 acetone sample reaches in the bulb 2. See here, acetone sample up to the marker, then we can start the stop clock. Here the acetone sample is fall from mark A to B, then we have to start the stop clock and we can note down the time period. See here, the 1 minute is required to acetone sample fall from mark A to B, the time period is 1 minute. 1 minute means that is the 60 second. So we can note down the 60 second. And same procedure we have to repeat for again acetone sample second time and third time for accurate reading. Note down this all reading in the observation table. Okay, so here we can write down the readings. These 3 readings of water sample. Water sample is reaches from mark A to B. In first reading 154 seconds is required, in second reading 90 seconds is required, and in third reading 75 seconds is required. Same procedure we have to repeat for acetone sample. Acetone sample requires 60 seconds to fall from mark A to B. Then in second reading 50 seconds is required, and in third reading 55 seconds is required. Then we have to take the average mean time. We have to take the average of these 3 values. We can add these 3 values and divide it by 3. This is the average time or average time in the second. That is the 106 second is required water sample to fall from the mark A to B. And in acetone, 55 second is required to fall from the mark A to B. Then here we have to determine the density by using the specific gravity bottle. So the water density is 1.2 gram per ml and acetone density is 0.97 gram per ml. So by using this time and by using the density, we can determine the viscosity. See here, for determination of viscosity, we can use this equation. So we can put the all values in this equation. So rho 2 is the 0.97 second. Rho 2 means density of the acetone. T2 means the time requires to fall from the acetone sample, that is the 55 second. So here we can write down the 55 second. Same, rho 1 means the density of the water, that is the 1.2. T1 means the time required to water fall from the mark A to B, that is the 106 second. And then multiplied with the viscosity of the water. So the viscosity of the water is known already, that is the 1.002. Okay. By calculating this all values, the final viscosity of the test liquid. Eta 2 it is called as the viscosity of the test liquid. So here by using this equation, we can determine the viscosity of the test liquid. That is the viscosity of the acetone sample. So here the viscosity of the acetone sample is 0.41 centipoise. The unit of the viscosity is centipoise or poise. We can write any units, either centipoise or poise. So the viscosity of the acetone sample is 0.14 centipoise. So here we can write down the viscosity of the acetone sample in observation table. 0.41 centipoise. See here, the water viscosity is 1 and test solution viscosity is, or acetone solution viscosity is 0.41. It means that as compared to the acetone sample, water viscosity is more as compared to acetone sample. Okay, it means the acetone sample viscosity is less as compared to the water sample. See here, the viscosity of the water is higher as compared to the viscosity of the acetone. So hence, we have to prove which liquid containing the higher viscosity and which liquid containing the lower viscosity by by using the Ostwald viscometer. Okay, and Ostwald viscometer we have to use only for the Newtonian fluid. It means the fluid containing the less viscous. Okay, thank you for watching this video.